pangin ko sa akong module.
Ay na, mag-deliver para ba kung anong mga inutaw? Ato lang sa imong ati patudlo, ha? Basi na kahinundong pa siya ni Ana ang eleksyon.
Dili ang kumusugot nga mapakang ang pagtuon sa atong kabataan. Bisan ubos kita sa pandemya karon, dawata kining gasa sa edukasyon, kinasingkasi nga halad gikan ning inyong pamunuan.
Gidalit kaninyo ni Mayor Edgardo Labella, Vice Mayor Michael Lopez Rama, ang Chairman sa Committee on Education sa atong konseho, Department of Education, Cebu City Division, Cebu City Local School Board ug Home Radio 106.7, kining Cebu City Educational Laboratory on Radio o Ed Radio. Ed Radio, atong dalit aron mas musayong ang pagkat-on sa atong mga tinunan gamit ang learning modules pinaagi sa pagpaminaw sa ilang mga paboritong teacher broadcasters sa kahanginan. Tune in na sa 106.7 kay matod ni Mayor ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.
Daman ang imuhang module. Kung maminaw na sa Ed Radio, kay magsugod na ang imuhang klase.
Yes, pa! Andam na ko! Come on, classmates! Pwede na ba mo sa ito ang klase karon? Maminaw ba ito ang tarong ni teacher, ha? Teacher! Andam na mi!
Good morning to our listeners, most especially to the awesome Grade 6 learners. How are you doing today? Wow, I am glad that you are doing great. Did you hear that? Do you know where are we going? You're right! We are going to explore the four wonders of Math Archipelago. We are going to conquer and be amazed by the beauty of Quarter 1, the major island of Math Archipelago, and earn the treasure in our first destination in Module 1, addition and subtraction of simple fractions and mixed numbers without or with regrouping. As we journey, you will be satisfied with knowledge in mathematics. In every lesson, you will be collecting the treasures to unlock each level and successfully achieve the greatest treasure at the end of the year. So, Grade 6 learners, are you ready for our treasure hunting adventure? Go grab your bag now with your Moodle, paper, and pen as your tools for today's adventure. This is Teacher Clyde, your treasure hunting master. Arat na! Hello, Grade 6 learners! Are you ready to discover our first treasure? Great! Do you still remember the four fundamental operations? Good job! Because these are helpful as we venture our lessons today. Grade 6 learners, welcome to our first destination. Before we proceed, make sure that you have already answered your pretest that is found on page 1 of your module. To check whether you already know about the topic, just follow the instruction, read, analyze, and answer each item on a separate sheet of paper. Now open to page 2 of your module and see lesson 1. Addition and subtraction of similar fractions and mixed numbers. What do we need to know about this lesson? At the end of this lesson, you are expected to first add similar fractions and or mixed numbers. Second, subtract similar fractions and or mixed numbers. Third, give the importance of being physically fit. Before we proceed to our first lesson, let us have a review of what's in on page 2 of your module. Do you still remember how to change improper fractions to a mixed number and mixed numbers to an improper fraction? Well, that's great! Open to page 20 of your module and compare your answer to the given answer key. Did you get a perfect score? Good job! Now turn your module on page 3 and see what's new. Are you excited for a new learning? Then let us read and analyze the given word problem. John and Michael are school athletes. During weekends, they jog around the school ground as part of their preparation for the upcoming events. If John covers 3 over 8 of a kilometer and Michael 6 over 8 of a kilometer in 1 minute, what is the total distance covered by the two athletes? Who are the athletes? Sean and Michael are the athletes. How do they prepare for the upcoming event? They jog around the school ground every weekend. Is it important to prepare ourselves for any event? Why? Yes, we need to prepare ourselves for any upcoming event so that we will be physically fit. Now let us answer the following questions in What Is It on page 3 of your module. How far did John jog? How about Michael? John jogged 3 over 8 of a kilometer and Michael jogged 6 over 8 of a kilometer. What is the total distance covered by the two athletes? To help us find the answer, let us follow the steps given on page 4 of your module. To find the total distance covered by the two athletes, we add 3 over 8 and 6 over 8. Since the two fractions are similar, we directly add the numerators and then write the sum as the new numerator. Afterwards, we copy the denominator. Simplify if necessary. To help us understand more, look at the given fractions. 3 over 8 plus 6 over 8. Add the numerator. 3 plus 6 equals 9. Copy the denominator. 8. So the answer is 9 over 8. Simplify the answer. So 9 over 8 is equal to 1 and 1 over 8. Therefore, the two athletes covered the total distance of 9 over 8 or 1 and 1 over 8 kilometers. To help us understand more about the topic, look at the example inside the two columns. Let us have the first column, how to add similar fractions. Before we proceed, just a quick reminder, there are two ways to read read a fraction, like the given example, 1 over 5 or 1/5. Now let's proceed to the given example. 1 over 5 plus 2 over 5. To get the sum of these two similar fractions, simply add the two given numerators and copy the denominator. Again, add the numerators. 1 plus 2 equals 3. Copy the denominator, 5. So the answer is 3 over 5. Now look at the example number 2. 2 and 1 over 4 plus 1 and 2 over 4. Since the given fractions are mixed numbers, we add the given whole numbers first. Next, add the given numerators and copy the denominator. So, 2 plus 1 equals 3. Then add the numerators. 1 plus 2 equals 3. And copy the denominator, 4. So, the answer is 3 and 3 over 4. Were you able to follow the steps? That's good. Now let us move to the next column. How to subtract similar fractions. Look at example number 1. 5 over 7 minus 2 over 7. To get the difference of the two fractions, simply subtract the two given numerators and copy the denominator. So, 5 over 7 minus 2 over 7. To get the difference of the two fractions, 5 minus 2 equals 3. Then copy the denominator, 7. Now look at example number 2. 5 and 3 over 5 minus 2 and 1 over 5. To get the difference of the two mixed and similar fractions, simply subtract the given whole numbers first. Next, subtract the given numerators and copy the denominator. To get the difference, subtract the whole number. 5 minus 2 equals 3. Next, subtract the numerators. 3 minus 1 equals 2. Then, copy the denominator, 5. So, the answer is 3 and 2 over 5. Did you able to follow the steps? Great job! To check your understanding of the topic, turn your module on page 5 and see what's more. Now, it's time for you to show your skills. Just follow the instruction, read, analyze, and write your answer on a piece of paper. You have 5 minutes to answer the activity. Now get your pen and your paper and start answering. How was it? Did you get the right answer? Now you are done. Compare your answers with those found in the answer key on page 20. Did you get the perfect score? Excellent! That means you have mastered the lessons. Now, before we proceed to the next lesson, just don't forget this special note in what I need to remember. To add similar fractions, we add the numerators. Write the sum as the new numerator and then copy the denominator. Simplify if possible. To subtract similar fractions, subtract the numerators, write the difference as the new numerator, and then copy the denominator. Simplify if possible. Isn't that simple? Congratulations! You have successfully collected the first treasure. Do not forget what you have learned today because this will be useful in your next lesson. Before we proceed, let us have a 30-second health break. Be right back!
Thank you.
Now let's proceed to page 5 of your module and see lesson 2, addition and subtraction of dissimilar fractions without regrouping. At the end of this lesson, you are expected to first, add dissimilar fractions without regrouping. Second, subtract dissimilar fractions without regrouping. And third, appreciate the importance of developing good study habits. Are you ready to discover the next treasure? That's great! But before that, let us review your previous lesson on what's in on page 6 of your module. In answering this activity, draw, color, and write your answer on a separate sheet of paper. I'll be giving you enough time to answer the activity. So go ahead, take your time, and I'll be right back. Alright, time's up! To check your answer, open page 20 of your module and compare your answer from the given answer key. Did you get the perfect score? Great job! You are very good in remembering the previous lessons. Now turn your module on page 7 and see what's new. Are you excited for a new learning? Then let us read and analyze the given word problem. It took Brian 3 over 8 of an hour to complete his math homework on Monday and 4 over 5 of an hour on Tuesday. How many hours did it take him to complete his homework altogether? Now let us answer the following questions. When did Brian do his homework? Brian did his homework on Monday and Tuesday. How long did Brian complete his homework on Monday? How about on Tuesday? Brian completed 3 over 8 of an hour on Monday and 4 over 5 of an hour on Tuesday. To help us solve the given word problem, let us answer the question in What is it on page 7 of your module. How many hours did Brian take to complete his homework altogether? To solve the total number of hours, we add 3 over 8 and 4 over 5. Since the two fractions are dissimilar, we need to get the LCD of the two fractions first, which is 40. Then, get the equivalent fractions and add the numerators. Afterwards, copy the denominator. Simplify if necessary. To expound that, look at the given fractions. 3 over 8 plus 4 over 5. The LCD of these two fractions is 40. Now let's divide 40 to each denominator and multiply it to the numerators. Let's start with the first fraction, 3 over 8. So 40 divided by 8 is 5. 5 times 3 is 15. So the new fraction is 15 over 40. Now let's move to the next fraction. 40 divided by 5 is 8. 8 times 4 is 32. So the new fraction of 4 over 5 is 32 over 40. Now, the two fractions are similar. You can now add the numerators. 15 plus 32 equals 47. Copy the denominator 40. So the answer is 47 over 40. Simplify the answer. To simplify, change the improper fraction 47 over 40 to a mixed number. So 47 over 40 is equal to
1 and 7 over 40.
Therefore, Brian spent 1 and 7 over 40 hours to complete his homework in math in 2 days. Is it important to do your homework?
Why?
Yes, it is important to do our homework so that we can finish and submit the task on time. To help us understand more about the topic, turn your module on page 8. You can see a box. Now let us have more examples in adding dissimilar fractions without regrouping. Here is the example number 1. 1 over 3 plus 2 over 10. Let us read and follow the steps. Step 1. Find the LCD by getting the least common multiple of 3 and 10. So here are the multiples of 3. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, and so forth. Now let us have the multiples of 10. Multiples of 10 are 10, 20, 30, and so forth. So the least common multiple of 3 and 10 is 30. So the LCD of 3 and 10 is 30. Step 2, write the equivalent fractions with the LCD of 30. To get the equivalent fraction, simply divide the LCD to the denominator and multiply it to the numerator. So 30 divided by 3 is 10. 10 times 1 is 10. So the new fraction of 1 over 3 is 10 over 30. Now let's proceed to the next fraction, 2 over 10. 30 divided by 10 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. So the new fraction of 2 over 10 is 6 over 30. Step 3, add the fractions. Since the two fractions are similar, add the numerators. 10 plus 6 equals 16. Then copy the denominator 30. Step 4, simplify the fraction to the lowest terms.
To simplify, find the greatest common factor of 16 and 30. The GCF of 16 and 30 is 2. So 16 divided by 2 is 8. 30 divided by 2 is 15. So the answer is 8 over 15. This time, let us have the example in subtracting dissimilar fractions without regrouping. 9 over 10 minus 1 over 2. Let us read and follow the steps. Step 1, find the LCD by getting the least common multiple of 2 and 10. So the multiples of 2 are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so forth. And multiples of 10 are 10, 20, 30, and so forth. So the LCD of 3 and 10 is 10. Step 2. Write the equivalent fractions with the LCD of 10. To get the new fractions, divide 10 to the given denominators and multiply it to the numerators. Let's begin with the first fraction. As you can see on the first fraction, 9 over 10, the new fraction is the same because when you divide 10 to the denominator, 10 is equal to 1 times to the numerator, 9. So the new fraction
is still 9 over 10. Now let's move to the second fraction. 10 divided by 2 is 5. 5 times 1 is 5. So the new fraction of 1 over 2 is 5 over 10. Step 3. Subtract the numerators and copy the denominator. So 9 minus 5 equals 4. Copy the denominator 10. So the answer is 4 over 10. Step 4. Simplify the fraction to its lowest terms. To simplify, find the GCF of 4 and 10. So the GCF of 4 and 10 is 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2. 10 divided by 2 is 5. So the final answer is 2 over 5. To check your understanding of the topic, turn your module on page 9 and see what's more. Now it's time for you to show what you have learned. Just follow the instruction, read, analyze, and write your answer on a piece of paper. Now get your pen and paper and start answering. Good luck, kids! Time's up! Now that you are done, compare your answers with those found in the answer key on page 20. Did you get a perfect score? Good job, kids! I know you can make it. That means you have mastered the lessons. Before we proceed to the next lesson, just don't forget this special note in what I need to remember. In adding or subtracting dissimilar fractions, change them to similar fractions first by getting the LCD. Find its equivalent fractions of the given fractions and proceed to addition or subtraction. Congratulations! You have earned 2 treasures. We are moving now on the third islet, where you can discover the next treasure. Are you ready? I know you are. Now open to page 9 of your module and see lesson 3, addition and subtraction of dissimilar fractions and mixed numbers with regrouping. At the end of this lesson, you are expected to first add dissimilar fractions and mixed numbers with regrouping. Second, subtract dissimilar fractions and mixed numbers with regrouping. And third, appreciate the importance of sharing. Now, before we proceed to our next lesson, let us have a review of what's in on page 1 of your module. Read the instruction carefully, analyze, and write your answer on a piece of paper. So go ahead, start answering, and I'll be right back. Alright, time's up! Did you follow the steps and get the right answer? Great! I know you can make it! Did you get a perfect score? Well done! That means you have mastered the lessons. Now turn your module on page 10 and see what's new. Are you excited for a new learning? Now let us read and analyze the given word problem. At the pizza party, Emerson and his friends shared and ate 3 and 4/7 boxes of Hawaiian pizzas and 1 and 3/5 boxes of pepperoni pizzas. How many boxes of pizza did they eat in all? To help us understand the given word problem, let us answer the following questions. What kind of party did Emerson and his friends attend? Emerson and his friends attended a pizza party. Is it important to share what you have with others? And why? You're right! It is important to share what we have for others. Because when sharing, we show that we care for them and we make them happy. It is good to see that you make people happy. To help us solve the problem, let us answer the following questions on what is it on page 10 of your module. How many boxes of Hawaiian pizza did they eat? How about pepperoni pizza? 3 and 4/7 of Hawaiian pizza and 1 and 3/5 of pepperoni pizza. How many boxes of pizza did they eat in all? To find the total boxes of pizza, we add 3 and 4/7 and 1 and 3/5. Since the two fractions are dissimilar and mixed numbers, we change the fractions into similar fractions using the LCD, which is 35. Afterwards, add the fractions followed by the whole numbers. Then, simplify if necessary. Now let us find the answer of 3 and 4/7 and 1 and 3/5. So 3 and 4/7 plus 1 and 3/5 is equal to open parenthesis 4/7 plus 3/5 close parenthesis and open parenthesis 3 plus 1 and close parenthesis. Now let's find the new fraction of 4 and 7 plus 3 and 5. To do that, find the LCD. To find the LCD, get the least common multiples of 7 and 5. So the LCD of 7 and 5 is 35. Now let's divide 35 by the denominator and multiply it to the numerator. Let's begin with the first fraction. 35 divided by 7 equals 5. 5 times 4 equals 20. Now let's proceed to the next fraction. 35 divided by 5 is 7. 7 times 3 is 21. So the new fractions are 20 over 35 plus 21 over 35. Now we can add the two similar fractions. 20 plus 21 equals 41. Copy the denominator, 35. This time, let us add the whole number. 3 plus 1 equals 4. So the answer is 4 and 41 over 35. Simplify the answer. To simplify, change the improper fraction into a mixed number. So 41 over 35 is equal to close and open parentheses 1 or 35 over 35 and close and open parentheses 6 over 35. Now you can add the two whole numbers. 4 plus 1 equals 5. So the final answer is 5 and 6 over 35. Therefore, Emerson and his friends shared and ate 5 and 6 over 35 boxes of pizza. To help us understand more about the topic, let us open your module on page 10 and continue it on page 11. Now let us have the example in adding simple fractions and mixed numbers with regrouping. To find the answer, let us follow the steps. Here are the given fractions: 5 and 2 over 3 and 1 and 3 over 4. Step 1, find the LCD or least common denominator of 2 over 3 and 3 over 4. To find the LCD of 3 and 4, get the least common multiples of 3 and 4. So the LCD of 3 and 4 is 12. Step 2, write the fractions as equivalent fractions using 12 as LCD. Add the numerators, then copy the denominators. To do that, simply divide 12 to the given denominators and multiply it to the numerators. Let's begin with the first fraction, 2 over 3. So 12 divided by 3 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. So the new fraction of 5 and 2 over 3 is 5 and 8 over 12. Now let us move to the next fraction, 3 over 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. So the new fraction of 1 and 3 over 4 is 1 and 9 over 12. Since the two fractions now are similar, we can now add the two numerators. 8 plus 9 equals 17. Copy the denominator 12. So you will have 17 over 12. Step 3. Simplify the fractional part from improper to mixed number. Then add the whole numbers. To simplify the fractional part of improper fraction, change it into a mixed number. Simply divide 17 by 12 and you will get 1 and 5 over 12. Now you can add the whole numbers. 6 plus 1 equals 7. So the final answer is 7 and 5 over 12. Now this time, let us have an example in subtracting mixed numbers with regrouping.
8 and 2 over 3 minus 5 and 5 over 6.
Let us read and follow the steps. Step 1, find the LCD. Get the equivalent fractions with the LCD of 6. Now let us get the equivalent fractions of 2 over 3 and 5 over 6. To do that, simply divide the LCD to the denominator and multiply it to the numerator. So 6 divided by 3 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. So the new fraction of 8 and 2 over 3 is 8 and 4 over 6. Now let's proceed to the next fraction. 6 divided by 6 is 1. 1 times 5 is 5. So the new fraction of 5 and 5 over 6 is also 5 and 5 over 6. Step 2, since the minuend fraction is smaller than the subtrahend, rename 1 or 6 over 6 from the whole number 8, then add. So 8 and 4 over 6 is equal to 7, open parenthesis, 6 over 6 plus 4 over 6, close parenthesis. Now get the sum of the two fractions inside the parentheses. 6 plus 4 equals 10. Copy the denominator, 6. So the answer is 7 and 10 over 6 minus 5 and 5 over 6. Step 3, subtract the numerators of both fractions, then copy the denominator. Subtract the whole numbers. Now let's subtract the numerators. 10 minus 5 equals 5. And copy the denominator. 6. Now subtract the whole numbers. 7 minus 5 equals 2. So the answer is 2 and 5 over 6. Simplify the answer if necessary. The final answer is 2 and 5 over 6. Now turn your module on page 12 and see what's more. Because it's time for you to show your skills. Just follow the instruction, read, analyze, and write your answer on a piece of paper. Don't you worry, because I'll be giving you enough time to think about it. Now get your pen and paper and start answering. Alright, time's up! How was it? Did you get the right answer? Great! Now that you are done, compare your answers with those found in the answer key on page 20. Before we proceed, don't forget this special note in what I need to remember. In adding the similar fractions and mixed numbers, find the LCD to get the equivalent fractions, add the numerators, and copy the denominator. Then add the whole numbers. Simplify if necessary. In subtracting the similar fractions and mixed numbers, find the LCD to get the equivalent fractions. Subtract the numerators and copy the denominator. Then subtract the whole numbers. Simplify if necessary. We regroup fractions when the numerator of the minuend is smaller than the numerator of the subtrahend. To do this, we borrow one from the whole number and rename or regroup it. Then add this to the fractional part. Simplify if necessary. Congratulations! You have earned the third treasure. Do not forget what you have learned today because this will be useful in your next lesson. Now open to page 13 of your module and see lesson 4, solving routine and non-routine problems involving addition and subtractions of fractions. What do we need to know about this lesson? At the end of this lesson, you are expected to first, solve routine problems involving addition and subtraction of fractions using appropriate problem-solving strategies and tools. Second, solve non-routine problems involving addition and subtraction of fractions using appropriate problem-solving strategies and tools. And third, appreciate the importance of eating healthy food. Let us have a review of what's in on page 14 of your module. Just read the instruction carefully, analyze, and write your answer on a separate sheet of paper. To check your answer, open page 20 of your module and compare your answer from the given answer key. How many scores did you get? Wow, you are amazing! Keep it up, kids! Now turn your module on page 14 and see what's new. Are you excited for a new learning? Then let us read and analyze the given word problem. Tiffany had 2 and 3 over 4 kilograms of bananas. She boiled 1 and 5 over 8 kilogram to be sold as afternoon snacks to the children in school. How many kilograms of banana was left for the next day? To help us understand more on the given word problem, let us answer the following questions. How many kilograms of banana did Tiffany have at first? Tiffany has 2 and 1 over 4 kilogram of bananas at first. How many kilograms of banana did she boil? She boiled 1 and 5 over 8 kilogram of bananas. Do you eat bananas for snack? Why? Because banana gives a lot of benefits in our body, such as it can give nutrients, it can also help our body boost its immune system, and can prevent us from any illnesses or diseases. So remember, always eat food like fruits and vegetables because it is good for our body. Now turn your module on page 15 and see what is it to help us find the answer. Let us follow the steps in solving word problems using AGONSA. Identify the following. What is asked? The number of kilograms of banana left. What are the given facts? 2 and 3 over 4 kilogram of bananas at first and 1 and 5 over 8 kilogram of banana was boiled. What operation to be used? Subtraction. Now write the number sentence. 2 and 3 over 4 minus 1 and 5 over 8 equals n. Now let us show the solution. Since the two fractions are dissimilar and mixed numbers, simply follow the steps in subtracting dissimilar and mixed numbers. To do that, find first the LCD of the two fractions, 3 over 4 and 5 over 8, which is 8. Then get the equivalent fraction using the LCD 8. So divide the LCD 8 to the given denominators and multiply it to the given numerators. Let's begin with 3 over 4. So 8 divided by 4 is 2. 2 times 3 is 6. So the new fraction of 2 and 3 over 4 is 2 and 6 over 8. This time, let us have 5 over 8. So 8 divided by 8 is 1. 1 times 5 is 5. So the new fraction of 1 and 5 over 8 is also 1 and 5 over 8. Subtract the whole number first. 2 minus 1 is 1. Then subtract the numerators. 6 minus 5 is 1. Then copy the denominator 8. So the answer is 1 and 1 over 8. Therefore, Tiffany had 1 and 1 over 8 kilograms of banana left. To help us understand more about the topic, turn your module on page 16 for another example. There are balloons for sale at the school fair. 7 over 10 of the balloons are blue, 1 over 5 are red, and the rest are yellow. If there are 9 yellow balloons, how many balloons are there in all? To help us visualize the problem, see the illustration inside the box of your module. To get the total number of balloons, get first the fractional part of the yellow. To get the fractional part of the yellow, simply subtract the sum of 7 over 10 and 1 over 5 from 1, since 1 represents the whole balloon. If in every 1 unit is equal to 9, then blue balloons has 7 units, so 7 times 9 is 63. Red has 2 units, so 2 times 9 is 18. And yellow has 1 unit, so 1 times 9 is 9. Therefore, there are 9 yellow, 63 blue, and 18 red balloons, or 90 balloons altogether. You can also find the total by thinking of units. If one unit is 9, then 10 units are equivalent to 90. Here is another way to solve the problem. First, find the LCD of 1 over 5 and 7 over 10 to get the sum of the fractions. Then find out what fraction of the balloons are yellow by subtracting the sum of 1 over 5 and 7 over 10 from 1, because the set of balloons is equivalent to one whole. To help us understand, look at the given fractions. 1 over 5 plus 7 over 10. Since these fractions are dissimilar, we need to find the LCD. So the LCD is 10. To get the equivalent fractions, we simply divide the LCD 10 by the denominators and multiply it to the numerators. Let's do that on the first fraction. 1 over 5. So 10 divided by 5 is 2. 2 times 1 is 2. So the new fraction of 1 over 5 is 2 over 10. Now let's move to the second fraction, 7 over 10. 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1 times 7 is 7. So the new fraction of 7 over 10 is also 7 over 10. Now add the numerators of the new fractions. 2 plus 7 equals 9. Copy the denominator 10. So 9 over 10 of the balloons are red and blue. Now let's subtract 9 over 10 from 1 to get the fractional part of yellow. So 1 minus 9 over 10 is also equal to 10 over 10 minus 9 over 10, which is 1 over 10. So 1 over 10 of the balloons is yellow. The problem says that there are 9 yellow balloons. So if 1 over 10 is 9 balloons, then 2 over 10 is 2 times 9 equals 18 red balloons, and 7 over 10 is 7 times 9 equals 63 yellow balloons. Add them all to get the total number of balloons. 9 plus 18 plus 63 equals 90 balloons. To check your understanding of the topic, turn your module on page 17 and see what's more, cause it's time for you to show your skills. So get your pen and paper and start answering. Alright, time's up. How was it? Did you get the right answer? Great! Now compare your answer on the answer key on page 20 of your module. Did you get a perfect score? Excellent! You are awesome! Now before we answer the activity on what I can do on page 18 of your module, just don't forget this special note in what I need to remember. Problem solving always begins with careful reading and understanding of the problem. Using the AGONSA steps facilitates the easy identification of the asked, given, operation, number sentence, solution, and answer. Now turn your module to page 18 and do the activity on what I can do. Just read the instruction carefully, analyze, and write your answer on a separate sheet of paper. So go ahead, get your pen and your paper, and start answering. Now get your pen and paper and start answering. Good luck, kids! up? How was it, kids? Did you get the right answer? Well done! I know that you can make it. Now that you are done, compare your answers with those found in the answer key on page 20. Did you get a perfect score? Well done! That means you have mastered the lessons. In case you have incorrect answers in some of the numbers, try to get back to your computation and check where you have been mistaken. Congratulations! You have successfully completed the four treasures. I believe you are excited to collect more treasures on your next treasure hunting adventure. But before we go, do not forget to answer the pretest on page 19 of your module to check the mastery of the lesson. Just read the instruction carefully, analyze and write the letter of your answer on a separate sheet of paper. Now that you are done answering, please don't forget to write on every answer sheet the following data: your complete name, grade and section, and name of the activity. And submit your answer sheet on the day agreed by the teacher. Please keep the module and return it at the end of the school year. I hope you had a wonderful time. We have just finished our first Mathinkable Math treasure hunting. Don't forget to bring your treasures with you as you move to the next level. Once again, this is Teacher Clyde, your treasure hunting master. Stay tuned for more math adventures here at 106.7 Ed Radio. Thank you and God bless us all.
Luca, anak, kamusta? Humanabain niyo ang klase?
Oo pa! Daghanap po niyo mga bagong nakatunan karon. Di ba, classmates?
Wow! Very good.
Classmates, magkuyog pi ang gihapon ta sa sunod na tuong klase, ha? See you!
Kadto ang atong kinasingkasing nahalad alang sa atong mga tinunan aron ang pagkat-on magpadayon bisan pa man sa mga kabag-uhan na resulta sa pandemya. Dalit kaninyo sa Cebu City Government Local School Board, Cebu City Council, Department of Education, Cebu City Division ug sa Home Radio 106.7. Atangi ang sunod na klase sa kahanginan. Hangtod sa sunod higayon, ayaw si Piata sa pagpaminaw sa Ed Radio tungod kay ang pagkat-on kinahanglan magpadayon.